I'm Narasimha, a third year research scholar, and here with me is Dr. Gargi Banerjee. She is a research scientist and a MOOC instructor. We both are from Educational Technology Department at IIT Bombay.
Hello Narasimha, so today what are we going to discuss?
We'll be discussing reflection spot. From the previous LCM courses, we have lots of questions from the participants. And we have categorized those questions under placement, conceptual, designing questions, closing the loop, and also assessment. So first we'll be discussing on placement related questions.
Okay, great. Let's get started then.
So the first question would be on, can reflection spot be inserted at the beginning of a learning dialogue?
Yes, reflection spot can definitely be inserted at the beginning of a learning dialogue. Whenever you have these sort of questions, think from the angle of a faculty. When you are going to teach your class, do you start your class with a question? I think many of you are nodding that you do sometimes start your class with a question. So exactly, in a MOOC setting also, you can start your learning dialogues with a reflection spot. Now, the second question associated with this is, in what kind of scenarios will you start your class with a question? So, I can think of two scenarios. One scenario is when I want to start off the class with a recap question, a recap of what I taught in my last class. Similarly, you can start your learning dialogue with a reflection spot question that recaps what you taught in the previous LED or learning dialogue. The second scenario that I can think of is you can ask a question to set the motivation for the content you are going to be teaching in this class. For example of this scenario too, let us see a short video clip. This is from the NPTEL course on digital marketing, and the topic the instructor is teaching is search engine marketing. So let's take a look at this clip.
Suppose you are struggling with the question and want immediate answer for that, or you want to buy a new product and want to know more about the features of this product, or you want to travel somewhere and want more information on that destination. Just tell me, from where will you get this information?
Now, if you have seen this clip, you will see the instructor started off with a reflection spot question, which prompts the learners or the students to think about the different purposes of using a search engine before he actually dives deep into the concept of search engine marketing. So in this way, you can definitely insert reflection spots at the beginning of learning dialogues. Now, associated with that, I would also like to answer another related point. Can you insert a reflection spot at the end of the learning dialogue? Now, the answer to that is, of course, you can insert a learning, your reflection spot at the end of a learning dialogue also. For example, I'm going to show you an example generated by a French faculty in one of our face-to-face LCM workshops. So she created a learning dialogue on French pronouns, and she ended the learning dialogue with the reflection spot question, what is the difference between tu and vu? Go to the discussion forum and discuss your answer. So this way you can also insert a reflection spot at the end. However, if you decide to insert at the end of a learning dialogue, a word of caution, remember that do not insert a reflection spot at the end of the learning dialogue and wait to give the feedback in the next LED. The feedback to a reflection spot should be immediate. It can be through the forum, but it should not be through another different learning dialogue. Therefore, to summarize, you can insert a reflection spot at the beginning, at the middle, or at the end of the learning dialogue. But if it's at the end, exercise caution. Your immediate feedback can be provided through the discussion forum. Next question.
So the next question is regarding like how long should the reflection spot pause should be, like any?
So reflection spot, how long it should be, it really depends upon the instructor. So it is your call how long you want it to be. If we have an 8 to 10 minutes long learning dialogue, we generally give, and this is a thumb rule, not a hard and fast rule, we give a pause of say 8 to 10 seconds. However, if you see on screen, if you are using a software like H5P, then you see that there is a typing box coming up on screen. And unless the learner completes typing and hits on the answer and proceed button, the video will not proceed. So these are the two ways of pausing the video.
So however, since the pause time is very few seconds, but whereas reflection spot requires learners to recollect and think about a particular issue, so wouldn't it take more than a minute?
Yeah, so reflection spot, generally when we are talking about reflection spots in the learning dialogues also in this LCM course, you will see that we have said that reflection spot is a question that should take not more than a couple of minutes to answer. Of course, it's going to take a few minutes to answer and your pause is in seconds. Then what can you do? What solution one is, if you are pausing the video for reflection spot, then you also instruct the learner that if you want to prolong the pause, hit the pause button. If you are using the H5P software, then this question doesn't arise because the pause time is at the hand of the learner. Until they finish responding to the reflection spot and they decide to hit the answer and proceed button, your video will anyway not proceed.
And the last question regarding under this category of placement, like for maximum how many reflection spot could there be in a learning dialogue?
So again, there is no hard and fast rule of what is the maximum, but there is a hard and fast rule of what is the minimum. So minimum there has to be one reflection spot question in a learning dialogue. So you can see on screen an example from the NPTEL course on designing of learner-centric e-learning course in STEM disciplines. So here you see the instructor has inserted 6 reflection spots in one learning dialogue. If you look on screen, you will see it starts with a very broad reflection spot question. What comes to your mind when you think of e-learning? And then the instructor goes on to give very specific examples one by one through the reflection spots, where the learner is guided to themselves concretize their idea of what they mean by e-learning. So in this case, there were 6 reflection spots in one learning dialogue. To summarize, therefore, you can have minimum, you should have 1, but how many you want is up to you as an instructor. Next question, Narasimha.
On placements, there are no more questions, so we can move on to the next part.
Okay, so then we conclude the part 1 on placement related queries of reflection spots here. Please go to the part 2 to see our discussion on the rest of the questions on reflection spots.
Thank you.
Thank you.